Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome to episode 60. We are in a new area. I'm just flying around to show you guys what exactly where we are, because I realized it was kind of hard to tell from the ground. Why is there lava in this biome? Anyway, so as you can see, I've picked out the new area to build in, and I've already done a little bit of work. I moved our beacon here and put it on haste. There was a mountain here about the size of this right here, I guess. And I flattened out, and I still got to do work. I can probably leave it stone, because snow's just going to cover it, right? I can probably just leave it stone. Anyways, how are you guys doing? I have plans for this place. Let's get into game mode 0 and cut down this tree while we're at it, because this is in the way. So what are we doing? If you guys recall, a stone golem was sent to attack our village, and we found out that was sent to us by some orcs. Hello, that is really loud on my end. Let's turn that down just a little bit. And that's exactly what we are building, a place for our orcs, and it's actually going to be an orc stronghold. So, it's a good thing that I actually brought that down, because I got a lot of stone from all this, quite a bit of dirt as well, which is all going to be very useful for us. So I'm going to get some of the stone out here, and we're going to do some planning. Now, this Hello? I'm clicking. Something is wrong with my mouse. I'm, like, clicking, and it's... I don't know. It's like, not registering right. I'm not sure what's going on. I'll keep playing and see if it becomes a problem. But anyways, this is going to be largely... Maybe. influenced or inspired by the strongholds in Skyrim. I'm talking like the bad guy strongholds, right? Like, they're kind of like mini castles, but they're not castles, but they always have walls outside of them. So the stronghold itself is going to be on this hillside, and I'm going to just lay out where the wall's going to be. My right click seems to be doing fine. And I don't know what's going on. I noticed it just before I started recording, but I was hoping that wasn't going to be an issue. So I'm going to start right here, because I don't know how permanent any of that area is going to be. So I'm just going to lay out where I think it's going to go. And while I do that, I want to discuss something with you guys. Now, I've made a small change to my channel. It really shouldn't be a big issue, but I've turned on ads. Now, I had turned off ads, pretty much really never used them. I used to use them a little bit, but then there was a change to the monetization on YouTube, and it was like, I had to set some things up. I'm going to have it go this way, and then integrate it into the wall, I think, or into this hill. You had to set something up to be able to use it, and I was like, well, I don't really make any money off of this, it's just a hobby, and the money that I do make off of it isn't really worth, I'm gonna make an area back here, hello, I didn't click twice there, my mouse is certainly acting up, whatever money that I was making off of it wasn't worth disrupting the viewing experience, which was my main concern. And then I kind of want to do something different. I want to have a regular wall all the way around. Maybe we can have some, like, a wood wall at some point. I definitely want to change something up. I don't want this wall going all the way around. But then System Z mentioned to me about how YouTube might not refer people to my channel as much because I don't create any ad revenue for them. So with that being said, ads have been turned on. I think you can choose what ads you get. So I want to make sure that I'm not showing the, like, 4-minute unskippable ads I get every now and then on other people's videos. I don't want that on my videos. So if anyone's getting those, let me know. And I'll see if there's something that you can do about that. Anyways, today is mostly going to be this wall. Oh, gosh. I was trying to click around the menu. Oh, there we go. And it changed my language. Like, it like automatically clicked a few times. English Canada? Is that going to make it like... Oh, here's English US. Hello? Minecraft. Hello? Okay, now I really don't know what I did. Options. Okay. Okay, just stop doing that. I might need new batteries, but my mouse is supposed to tell me when I need new batteries, and it's not telling me. Anyways, I'm gonna get to smelting some stuff, because we're gonna need some smooth stone. I have another chest of stone in here, and that has a little bit. Let's go ahead and make some ferni. That would be plural, so there we go. But yeah, not trying to disrupt anyone's viewing experience. Not doing it for the money, because there really isn't a whole lot to be had for me. It's really just, I don't want YouTube like algorithms saying, hey, this guy is not important, he doesn't bring us any money, let's not do anything for him. So I'm just going to do a very, very small portion of the wall, like right between these, and kind of use it as a template for the rest. So let's get our cobble. I kind of want some stone brick. Let's just turn half of this into stone brick. I realize I didn't need a crafting bench for that. Okay, so I'm trying to think. I don't want this like a super clean wall. I kind of want this. This is supposed to be like orc bandits. So I want it to be fairly messy and dirty. So let's just say I want to be able to walk on top of it as well. So let's just say that it's 3 wide on the top. So this is a very rough sketch. And I don't want it to be straight up. And, you know, I want to have some groove in it. So let's do something like this. Even something like that. Yeah, and I kind of just want, let's just make the template all out of cobblestone, and then we'll replace it with the stone bricks and whatnot. How high do I want this? I want this to be fairly high. This is a protected structure, theoretically. So I'm thinking I might pull inspiration from one specific hold, called the, what is it? Mistwatch? It has 3 towers on it, but at the same time, I'm kind of tired of towers. See, now this is very boring. Let's make it a little wider so I have some freedom while I'm doing this little template here. Yeah, you can see that my tools took a bit of a beating while I tore that thing down. Gonna need a lot of cobblestone, or a lot of stone in general. This can probably get filled in with dirt, so I'm just going to fill that out like that, and fill in the rest of it just like this. This should be high enough. I want to get a sense of how this feels from a ground perspective. So that's pretty good. Now that's going to be the level of the walkway, I think. So people are going to walk at this height. So that gives us freedom to vary the top of the wall by a block, block and a half, half a block, whatever. And that'll do us a lot. I want to like make this part right here damaged, kind of. So like knock it in like that, and then I want this also sticking out a little bit right there, right? So this thing's gonna be fairly like makeshift pieced together. Something like that. Now, that almost looks like there's been a fight here before, which there probably has been, right? And there's a hole in the wall. I'm just going to get rid of my inventory. It's like, I don't need this stuff. All this wood that I don't need it for this build. Why is this not lumping with that? Hello? I'm going to need more of that. Okay, so I'm gonna mix up the texture of this wall, and then I'll be back. Ah, now that is more or less how I want it. Although, I kind of wish that I could define that there's a walkway here a little better from the outside. Now, from the inside, you'll be able to see, you know, there's going to be, like, these in half slabs. And I can maybe even set these half a block down. Yeah, that seems like a good idea to me. Ooh, walls. Walls are what I'm forgetting. So, and we can switch out some... We're going to have to put some bricks in here. Now, my goal with this build is that there is no dull areas. Now, this is a very plain wall right here. But I want points of interest all over. So, maybe this is plain... But there's like an entrance right there. Maybe there's a wooden aspect to the wall right here. Maybe there's a building tied into the wall right here, right? There's this right here is plain, like I said. I kind of want to do the entrance and see how that would work. I wish I didn't build this thing so close to it. I don't get a good view of it. You're throwing off my groove. I can't really get a good feel of what's going on here. Walls would definitely help show that that is a walkway, though. So let's just... mouse, please. We can get rid of the shovel because I'm not shoveling anything. So let's just put that right there. And maybe right there. Like that. Does that tell me more easily? Yeah, I think so. We can have some sort of tower in the wall as well. Towers. I've been doing so many towers lately, haven't I? Just gonna take a quick sleep. So this would be a pretty good spot for the entrance, I think. I kind of want to take a page from the book of the Farmer's Guild here. And use fence as a gate structure. I had the fence in the ground on that gate, so it's like in the ground and it gets raised up. I kind of want it... Man, what if I did a closed gate and then there was like a secret entrance into it? That could be cool, right? So like, let's get some dirt. We have dirt. I need to do some terraforming. So let's just fill this in. And all filled in. Now, So it's going to obviously go right in the middle, which would be right here, assuming that there's no change. I do want to make a change, actually. I want to move the whole... I want to shift the whole thing over like this. And then, just for now, let's put these down. Does that really not get rid of snow? Oh, I wonder if that's an Optifine thing. That might be an Optifine thing. Which is fine. That's cool, right? Like, that's kind of how you wish that it would interact with water. Let's make this at least 5 wide. At least. You know, we could even have, like, a hole... like a hole at the gate, like the fence itself is not complete. I don't know. I think it'd be a cool part of the story if we had some sort of infiltration aspect. So maybe this will be closed. We don't even know why these people sent the stone golem yet, though. So let's keep that in mind. Now that would put that... I think the walking We can have the pathway go up half a block if it needs to. That's fine. So let's just do this. And I'm going to just work out the frame. Okay, we're going to have to do something a little creative here. Now, I wanted this gate to go up instead of into the floor because we've already done something like that before. So what I'm going to do is... okay, that works. I created a makeshift way up here, by the way. Definitely temporary. And definitely out of my skill level. I'm going to cover this up with wooden trapdoors if my mouse allows it. Hope I don't need a new mouse. Well, that's okay, but you need to definitely go to this side. Give me... I like to think that was less time spent than getting the axe out. That will open up the same way. So, if you were to open this up, that would open, and then this is closed when the gate itself is closed. Yeah, I like that. So now I really just need to make sure that you can't do this and dress it up the same way that is dressed up, and I'll be right back. This is a pretty good start to this wall, and this is more or less where I'm going to leave off for this, but let's go over some of the things I've done. So I extended it all the way over here. The backside is not detailed out like this. I added some stairs to look like missing bricks and whatnot. I talked about how I want like points of interest all along the wall, so it's not just a continuous wall. I like this, adding in like a support that's supposed to be hidden away by the rock, but the rock's been broken away. Here's a door that used to be functional, and they've blocked it off for whatever reason. So I think that's pretty cool. I like that detail, actually. I go super fast now. I changed the buff on my beacon to speed, so we can go really fast. I added this chimney here. I'll have to get some spiderweb or something up there. Some wool. I don't know. Glass, maybe. But this is supposed to be like a little smithing area. I'll do more of that. And then here's a stairway to get up here. And then, you know, still have to do, you know, this really didn't take me that long. I could, the rest will be off camera work, but, you know, bring it over to here. And then, this is kind of going to be like the, I want to say courtyard, but it's not a courtyard. The front yard area of this, stone keep is going to be in here. Like basically everything up until the edge of this hill. I'm going to be free to fill up with, you know, whatever kind of stuff that you would put outside. But I really like the size of this. I really like how this wall is turning out. And I hope you guys do too. If you have any other suggestions for the wall, I can definitely fit in a tower into it. You know, some sort of point of infiltration. I was thinking, actually, if we head over here, there's a cave that could be, you know, we could maybe tie in where they've just kind of ignored the cave over here. Or maybe it, you know, part of the cave sneaks under the wall just a little bit and then you can get in on the backside. But yeah, it's going to be interesting. I'm not entirely sure how I'm going to fill up this entire hill with stuff or if I will or what. This is a good size hill, though. I like it. This is going to be a fun little project, I think. It'll be, you know, I haven't built... It'll be comparable to the Farmer's Guild, but I think I'll have more creative liberties to ignore architecture and just build, if that makes sense. A big part of that, what held me back on the Farmer's Guild was... You know, figuring out how the walls would work well together, but this is, it's stone, a lot of stone. I think this will be easier for us. So, thank you for watching, everybody. I hope you enjoyed. I hope you're enjoying the new, more frequent uploads. Tree saplings for wood. and yeah, that's pretty much it. Thank you guys. Bye.